Good morning, Vandan. Today we are going to discuss briefly about some variants of K-nearest-neighbor algorithm. Let's have a look into this weight classification problem once again. Let us consider two features, x1 and x2. x1 corresponds to roll number of the student and x2 corresponds to height of the student in centimeters, and y corresponds to class label. We are trying to categorize each of the student into either class 1 or class 2 or class 3 or class 4 based on the weights. Let us have a look into those classes. The student is in between 40 kgs to 50 kgs weight, class 1, 50 to 60 class 2, 60 to 70 class 3, above 70 class 4. Like that we want to classify. And if you try to apply intuition, if you try to think about this one, there is no relevance between weight of the student and roll number. In general, there won't be any relevance at all between weight of the student and roll number, because the roll number will be assigned based on the alphabetical ordering of the names, right? There is no relevance between this roll number and weight. There is some relevance between height and weight. In general, if the height is bit high, we can expect weight also will be higher. In general, this can be expected. Right? There is some correlation between this and this, but there is no relation at all between this and this. Now, with the help of these two features, if you want to estimate the weight of the new person, unknown person, which is not part of this table. For example, if I consider some student X, some new student X, and if I measure the height of the student as x2t, the test, t means test student, is the height of that student, and x1t for the test student, this is the roll number. Now with the help of them, and if you try to apply k-nearest neighbor algorithm, what we are going to get is, your training examples are as follows. It's a notation for ith training example, xi. The dimension of this one is 2 cross 1. This can be written as xi1. This is a roll number. xi2. This is the height of the student. This corresponds to your training set or training data. Along with this, you are going to have class label also, yi. This class label also will be given in your training data. But this class label is not given for your test data. You need to find this label. Our target is, we need to find what is yt. That is our target. Let's assume that you have training data. Number of training samples we are going to have is up to n. Let's assume like this one. You are having n training samples with you. I equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on, n. What k-nearest neighbor classifier will try to do is, that will try to find the Euclidean distance between this particular feature vector with all those n feature vectors. For I equal to 1, I equal to 2, I equal to 3 and I equal to n. For all of them, it will try to find the Euclidean distance. And after finding the Euclidean distance, we will try to arrange them in the ascending order. And we will try to consider top k out of those ascending order Euclidean distances. The top k, nearest k, like that you can think. Nearest k we will consider. Out of the nearest k, whichever is corresponding to majority class label, that label will be assigned to your test sample x1t and x2t. That's what we are going to do. We are going to assign that class label to this one based on majority. If there is a regression problem instead of this classification problem, then you can go for average of all those k samples. K nearest neighbor regression means we will try to find the nearby samples to nearby k samples to this one, And once you found the nearby K samples, the concerned K labels will be there, right? A concerned K Y values will be there. We'll try to take the average of all those K Y values that corresponds to our prediction or our regression value for this particular sample. In that way, we will do. If that is regression, we'll go for average. If that is classification problem, we'll go for majority class out of those K. And if you try to have that Euclidean distance, this is the Euclidean distance. Euclidean distance between our test sample XT and ith training sample. This can be written as follows. In our example, we are having only two features, right? XT1 minus XI1 whole square plus XT2 minus XI2 whole square. This corresponds to roll number, this corresponds to height of the student. And if you try to analyze this one, this roll number don't have any impact on the weight of the student, right? It's irrelevant. We can treat it like a noise, right? This is almost like a noise because it's irrelevant for us. It's unnecessarily adding some extra bias to you, right? This can be treated as a noise. That means irrelevant feature is same as noise to your classification algorithm. This is behaving like a noise to your classification algorithm because this will never contribute anything to your weight. Whatever you are adding this extra term, that is called as noise in this case. Irrelevant feature, which is trying to add noise. This is irrelevant feature. Height and weight are a bit relevant, right? This is irrelevant feature. That means we are going to have some noise in your classification, right? This will create huge problem. In that case, you can go for weighted Euclidean distance. Weighted Euclidean distance means that can be written as follows. Weighted Euclidean distance between XT bar comma XI bar can be written as follows. Square root of W1 into XT1 minus XI1 whole square plus W2, W1, W2 are the weights, into XT2 minus XI2 whole square. This is a weighted Euclidean distance. In our example, this is irrelevant feature, right? Irrelevant feature to our classification task. This is almost behaving like a noise to our system. It's better to nullify this one. In this particular example, try to make this weight like 0. This weight is 0. And let's make this weight like 1. W2 equals to 1 and W1 equal to 0. If you try to make W1 as 0, then this will be nullified or this can be removed from the system, right? 0 into something is 0. Then your Euclidean distance or weighted Euclidean distance is just a function of second feature, which is height. It's just a function of height, right? So weighted Euclidean distance measure looks good as compared to your just Euclidean distance measure, right? It is preferable, weighted Euclidean distance. Similarly, suppose if you are having D features with you, or let's assume that D equal to 3, 3 features with you. XT bar equals to, for example, the test data XT1, XT2, second feature. This is third feature. And let's consider ith training example as follows. XI1, XI2 and XI3, and you are having n such training examples, 1, 2 and so on up to n such training examples, and along with this concerned label YI also given, because this is training example. For this we need to find YT, that unknown Y output label. Suppose this first one, first feature is the irrelevant feature for our classification task, and let's assume that second feature is most important as compared to third feature for our classification problem. This feature is most important compared to this feature, third feature, for classification problem, and this is irrelevant feature. Then that can be written as follows. Weighted Euclidean distance can be written as follows. Weighted Euclidean distance between XT, XI can be written as follows. Square root of W1 into XT1 minus XI1 whole square plus W2 into XT2 minus XI2 whole square plus W3 into X3T minus X3I whole square. If this is irrelevant feature, for example feature 1 is irrelevant, then you can try to make it like 0. Feature 1 is irrelevant. And let's assume that feature 2 is more important for classification. Then third feature, then what we can do is we can try to have the weights as follows. W2 bigger than W3. For example, you can take W3 equals to 0.1 and W2 equals to some 0.8. 0.8 into this one plus 0.1 into this one. We are giving more weightage for feature 2 as compared to feature 3. This is just an example. You can try to assign different weights for different features, right? That can be assigned. It's possible. For that, we can go with weighted Euclidean distance measure instead of direct Euclidean distance. And one more thing. Distance weighted k nearest neighbor. Distance weighted k nearest neighbor means, for example, if you are having class 1 samples as follows and class 2 samples, the other class 2 samples. These are class 2 samples, and this is your test sample. Your test sample means, now we need to assign a class for this one. For example, consider k equal to 5, 5 nearest neighbor, right? We will try to find the distance to this test point from all these training samples. And we will try to figure out best 5 nearest samples to this one. In this case, this is the nearest one, and second nearest one is, this looks like second nearest one, third nearest one, the fourth nearest one, And fifth nearest one looks like this, right? This is a fifth nearest one. In general, what we will do is, we'll try to go by majority. Majority means, in this case, we'll try to assign it like a class 2. This is class 1, this is class 2, right? 3 out of 5 are nearer to this test sample from this class 2. So that you can try to go by majority rule. You can try to assign class 2 for this one. If that is a regression problem, then you need to go for average of all these 5 values. We'll have the concerned y values for them, right? That output values. We'll try to take the average of them. y1 plus y2 plus y5 divided by 5. That is classification, we are going by majority. But what distance weighted KNN means is, we'll try to give the more weightage to the sample which is nearer to this one. For example, consider this test sample. This sample is much nearer to this one, right? Let's try to have some naming for them. This sample 1 is much nearer to this one. After that, this second sample is nearer to that. After that, this third sample is nearer to that. Next, this fourth sample is nearer to that. Fifth sample is nearer to this one. This is much nearer compared to this sample, right? We'll try to give more weightage for this particular sample for the decision making purpose. For decision making purpose, we are trying to give more weightage for the nearest sample. For this sample, we'll try to give the more weightage. For this sample, we'll try to give the less weightage for the decision making purpose. That's called as distance weighted k nearest neighbor. In this case, weight between test sample and ith training sample is as follows: 1 divided by Euclidean distance. The Euclidean distance between test sample feature vector and ith sample feature vector. The Euclidean distance. Weight assigned to ith feature is as follows. Suppose this ith feature is in top 5. When k equals to 5, this is in the top k samples of your k nearest neighbor algorithm. Suppose this ith sample, then the weight assigned to this one is as follows: 1 divided by Euclidean distance between ith feature vector and this test sample. Euclidean distance, this is the concerned weight we are going to assign. That can be generalized as follows: once you apply your k nearest neighbor algorithm and if you try to figure out the top k samples out of them. For example, the top k samples you got are as follows: tenth sample, these are the top k samples, 13th sample and x21, and let's consider k equals to 5. These are the top k samples that you got. Once you got the top k samples with you, what you are going to do is, for example, this corresponds to class 1, this corresponds to class 2, this corresponds to class 2, this corresponds to class 2, and this corresponds to class 1. For example, if this is the case, then what we are going to do here is, we'll try to add all those weights. Weights means, for class 1, This is the final weight we are going to get. 1 divided by d of x bar 10 comma xt is a weight for this side. This weight will be added to this weight. Euclidean distance of x51 comma xt. Sum of those weights corresponds to this class label 1. Similarly, we will try to add for class label 2. This is with the class label 2. We will try to add all the 3 weights. The weight of this one is 1 by d of x13 comma xt, 1 by d of x21 comma xt, plus 1 by d of x32 comma xt. We will try to add those weights. If this weight is bigger than the sum of the 3 weights, then you can classify it as class omega 1. If this sum of weights is bigger compared to this sum of weights, then you can try to assign xt with a label of omega 2, class 2. Like that you can assign. When coming to regression problem, you can do it as follows. You can simply do this for the regression case. W1 Y1 plus W2 Y2 plus W3 Y3, W4 Y4 plus W5 Y5 for the regression case, Y hat equals to, where Y1 corresponds to, yeah, let us have this same notation. This is Y10. This is Y13, right? This is Y13. Next one is Y21. Next Y32. And next one is Y51. This is the output of your regression problem, k nearest neighbor, phi nearest neighbor regression problem. The weighted sum of all those outputs. But after that, we need to do the average. Average means W1 plus divided by W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4 plus W5. You need to do this one, where W1 corresponds to Euclidean distance between x10 comma xt. W2 corresponds to, this is not Euclidean distance, right? 1 divided by Euclidean distance. 1 divided by Euclidean distance. W2 corresponds to 1 divided by Euclidean distance between x13 comma xt. And similarly, W3 corresponds to 1 divided by Euclidean distance between x21 and xt. W4 corresponds to 1 divided by Euclidean distance between x32 bar comma xt bar. And W5 corresponds to 1 divided by Euclidean distance between x51 bar comma xt bar. It's average, right? That's why you are going for divide by total sum. Because sum of the weights should be equal to 1 when you are doing the average, weighted average. That's why you are going for this extra normalization factor for regression case. When there is k nearest neighbor regression problem, then you can go by this way. When there is classification, you can go by majority weight. In this case, class 1 weights you will try to add and class 2 weights you will try to add. Whichever the weight is bigger, that class label will be assigned to your test sample XT. Thank you.